7 feet. Barren, strange fruit. Blood on the leaves. And blood at the roots. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze. Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene of the gallant South. Them big bulging eyes. And the twisted mouth. Scent of magnolia, clean and fresh. Then the sudden smell of burning.
God rest you, Mrs. Bronson, good morning.
Is she
nice in? To see you back. She
I
is.
I have an emergency. I need to see her right away.
Is there something I can do
no,
for you?
No, I need to see her.
Well, I think she's back here somewhere.
Rosa.
Hello, Mrs. Bronson.
I have a catastrophe on my hands, and it can only be entrusted to you.
Okay. Well, let's take a look. Oh. Well, don't you worry. This will not be a problem.
Oh, thank you, dear. You are the most talented woman in Montgomery, and I would be lost without you.
Well, that is very kind of you to say.
I'm just stating a fact.
Miss Bronson, I got something to show you. Would you mind?
Thank you.
Oh, of course, of course.
I think you'll just love it.
I can wash out 44 pairs of socks and have them hanging out on the line. Starch and iron 2 dozen of shirts before you can count from 1 to 9. I can strip up a great big dipper full of lard from the drippings can. Throw it in the skillet, go out and do my shopping, be back before it melts in the pan, 'cause I'm a woman. W-O-M-A-N.
It looks so much better if you just lose some weight.
Mama, I tried.
I'll go look for a shawl.
You look beautiful, miss. You're gonna be the most beautiful girl at the party. Secret is how you carry yourself. Your shoulders back, your head held high, and smile. A smile like you're holding a secret. You'll be a showstopper for sure.
Are we done here?
Yes, ma'am. Should be ready tomorrow at 3 o'clock.
Thank you. Well, go change. Got a lot more to do, and your father's waiting.
Come in, baby. Sit
down. Morning, Mr. Parks.
Read it.
Lynching rule justified.
Yeah. What do you think about that?
It can't be true, Mr. Parks. It can't.
You know, Emmett Till could have been a Brooklyn Dodger. He could have been the next Roy Campanella. You see these people? They want us playing ball and entertaining them. They don't want us to have this thing called justice. You're doing a good job on that floor, son. Big day today. Big day. Big day.
Thank you, sir. I'll get back to work.
Well, that little nigger boy got what he deserved. He had no right to be talking, let alone whistling at her.
That's right.
Can you imagine? That poor woman must have been terrified.
Mm-hmm. Well, I am just grateful to God that the whole mess is over and done with, and justice has been served.
Well, they had no right to arrest Mr. Bryant in the first place. Protecting his wife's honor is all he was doing. How's that against the law these days?
Well, that boy should have known his place.
After Emmett Till was murdered, I felt like I saw him in every young boy I passed. Who could have imagined that a sweet 14-year-old boy would be dragged from his bed in the middle of the night, tortured, killed, and thrown into the river for allegedly whistling at a white woman?
Mr. Gray?
Mrs. Parks, this is a planned surprise. I was expecting you to stop by today. Please come in, have a seat, please.
Oh, I hope you don't mind.
Of course not, have a seat, please.
Oh, thank you, Freddie.
Take your coat for you.
It's been a challenging day.
Sure it has been.
Just thought I could use some company.
Of course, anytime. I trust you've seen this? Mm.
Some white folks at my store were talking about how the acquittal is justice.
Yeah.
I don't understand. How can those monsters go unpunished for his murder? Freddie, I just keep seeing poor Emmett's face. It's all beat up. Mr. Gray, what is the point of a trial if they can do whatever they want with complete disregard for the law?
Because the laws of this country were built to favor the white man. I'm afraid it's just as simple as that. But I guess that's what I'm trying to do here.
Mm.
Hmm? Even things out a little.
Yes, of course.
Oh, goodness. I have to run down to the records office.
Oh, go.
Could you cover for me, please?
Go on, Freddie.
I won't be but longer than 20
yeah,
minutes.
Go. Law office.
Now, I was trying my best to concentrate on work, but my mind was distracted with plans for the two-day NAACP workshop I was set to lead that coming weekend. Now, as secretary of the Montgomery chapter, I was responsible for a lot, and these workshops were my favorite tasks.
Just to start. We're gonna keep seeing this, and it's gonna get worse because they become emboldened now. Law said it was justified because they were crossing on
yes,
private
ma'am.
Land.
Mr. Parks.
Yeah.
Telephone for you.
Excuse me, just a second. Hello. Hello.
Hello, dear. I'm heading to the bus. Could you pick up a quart of milk?
No problem. I can pick that up on the way home.
Thank you. I'll see you soon.
Hey, careful out there. All right. Love you too.
You know who that was.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Thank you.
me have them front seats. You hear me? Look, now y'all need to make it light on yourself now and get on up and have them seats. Huh? Move that sign back. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
There you go.
All right, sir, you can come ahead on now and move it in. Why aren't you standing up?
I don't think I should have to.
Excuse me, are you gonna move?
No. No, I'm not.
Now listen to me. If you don't move, I'm gonna call the police and they'll arrest you. You know I'll do it.
You may do that then.
All right. Yes, operator, I need the police department, please. Yes, I have a disruptive passenger on one of my buses. This is a Cleveland Avenue bus, and I'm in front of the Empire Theater. You can't miss us.
All right, who's making trouble here?
Why didn't you stand up when the driver spoke to you?
I don't believe I should have to.
And why is that?
I'm not sitting in the white section.
Get on up out this bus now, you hear?
Ma'am, don't make this tough on yourself. Come on.
Why do you push us around?
Law's the law and you're under arrest.
Stragglers at the shop, so.
Hello, Raymond.
Hey, good evening. I got the milk. Where's Rosa?
Well, she's not here. I thought maybe the two of you had met up somewhere.
No, she. She called me from work and she should be home by now.
Well, maybe there's some. Delay on the road.
Are you thirsty?
Pardon?
You've got a drinking spell. They usually don't give us color folk a cup till you figure out you got an ass full. Most of them don't work anyway. I got one that does.
Thank you, ma'am.
What happened to you? How'd you find your way in here?
I was arrested on the bus.
Some of them bus drivers are pretty nasty.
You get hurt?
No.
That's good. Are you married?
Yes, I am.
Good. You know your husband ain't gonna let you stay in here, so don't you worry.
Are you married, ma'am?
Once.
My husband, he passed away a few years back. Sure was something else. Now I'm in here. Cause this fella I was keeping company with thought he could knock me around. Problem was he didn't know me too well. He had my mouth bleeding and my eye nearly swole shut. I went on back, grabbed that hatchet out shit. He just laughed. And then he didn't. But I've been in here ever since. 50, maybe 54 days now.
Why so long?
Told me he dropped the charges if I stayed on with him. I told him I'd rather rot in jail than to be with a man who thinks he can beat on me.
I don't know that I could be that brave.
I just figured some things are worth standing up for. And that bus driver, he raised a hand to you?
No. He moved the sign to the white section, and I refused to give up my seat.
You in here talking about me being brave? Sounds like what you did was brave enough for lots of us. Give me your hand, sister.
Hello.
Mama, it's Rosa. Is Parks there?
Honey, where are you? Oh, my God. Did they beat you, honey?
Rosa.
Hi. I'm okay, but I need you to come get me out of jail.
I'll be there as soon as I can.
Yes, I'm holding for... That's right. Mrs. Rosa Parks. Well, what's the charge? Hello? Hello?
Clifford, Mr. Nixon's on the phone. He said it's an emergency.
Mr. Nixon.
Good evening, officer. My name is Clifford. I'm Mrs. Parks' attorney.
That's so.
Yes, it is.
You all sit down. We'll get to you.
They didn't hurt you, did they?
No, I'm fine.
I'm Miss Fox, tell me.
You all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
Thank you all so much for coming.
Raymond is on his way.
You'll need to sign here.
You all right?
Yes.
We paid her bail. Court date set for Monday. She's free until then.
We've been waiting for this opportunity.
She's perfect. And you know it. Rosa, you know, ain't nothing gonna change around here unless we have a movement.
Too dangerous. Dangerous, Nixon.
3 weeks ago, they determined it was illegal for a transportation company to impose their segregation rules on interstate transportation. Oh, come on.
And although that was a great victory, it does not speak to the rules of the city. What we need is a fully integrated city buses.
What are you all talking about?
Claudette Colvin, Aurelia Browder, Susie McDonald, and a host of other Negro women who've been arrested or removed from city buses for not giving up their seats to white passengers. We've been trying to plan a bus boycott for nearly a year now.
And you want Rosa to get mixed up in that?
We want Rosa to lead the boycott.
No. No. No.
You don't want to put my wife up in the front of this thing? Put a target on her back? Huh?
You were lucky that they didn't beat you last night.
No. You're gonna have to find someone else.
Oh, there is no one else.
Well, how can that be?
Because we've been looking for an upstanding citizen with a good job from a decent family to represent our cause.
But why can't some of those other women, why can't they lead it?
Look, those other women had issues. One of them was an unwed teen. The other one would have had an alcoholic husband. And the other woman, just quite frankly, she just wasn't strong enough to lead.
My question is, are you gonna be safe, Rosa? Is your mother going to be safe? If you go out here threatening their laws, their way of life, they're hanging people for less than this.
And they will continue to do that unless we stand up against them together.
Go outside and have a smoke. That's my wife.
What would she have to do?
Well, first thing is we would need to protest her unjust arrest by a one-day bus boycott. Hmm?
And what good would that do?
Oh, we colored folks only, we make up about 70% of the riders in all of Montgomery.
That's nearly 40,000 riders. Mm-hmm.
So that's 10 cents each way. That's 4,000 one way, 8,000. A day.
They'll listen then.
You know white folks don't.
No. We cannot be concerned about what white folks think and do. We can't keep living like that. I mean, it's 1955, and we're still following the same rules as Jim Crow in the 1890s. You tell me. Why is it we can choose to sit anywhere we want, in New York City, in Los Angeles, in Chicago, but we can't choose where we want to sit in the old city where we were born. Rosa, we either stand to fight or we remain slaves.
How are they gonna do a boycott? People suffering. People's life is hard enough. They're not gonna stick the neck out for anybody.
This isn't that different from all those years you worked trying to get justice for the Scottsboro boys.
No, that was different.
We reorganized. We got a force of people behind us.
We? Who the we? What we are you talking about? The we that's gonna escort you to work in the morning? The we that's gonna walk you home at night while I'm still at the shop? The we that's gonna put 24-hour security detail on our home?
Parks, when I saw those police officers walking towards me, I knew I should have been afraid, but I wasn't. I saw young Emmett's face. And all the women that were there before me.
All those women who were there before you are not you, Rosa. They are not my wife. Rosa, you know I understand. I do. Darling, what you did tonight made me so proud. And I know that I could sit here and try to frighten you, but you don't scare so good.
Today I made a choice. You would have made the same choice. Okay. Let's begin.
We need to get the word out. Fred Gray.
Hello, Mr. Gray. I heard about what happened to Mrs. Parks. Is she all right?
I don't know.
You know, we have talked about this long enough. The time for a boycott is now, Mr. Gray.
Yes, I just spoke with Mr. Nixon, and we're ready to put things in motion.
Good. As president of the Political Women's Council, I have already alerted the members, and we are ready to put our money and our support behind this.
Thank you. A bus boycott is to be held on Monday, December 5th, same day as Rosa's trial.
I will be able to have the handbills printed up announcing it tonight.
I'm sorry, tonight? If we're going to do this, we will need to notify the entire Negro community of Montgomery.
Don't worry, just leave it to us.
Mrs. Robinson, you'll need to be cautious.
I'll be in touch. Hello? Daisy? Professor Robinson here. I have a project I need you to help me with. Meet me on campus in 15 minutes. Uh-huh, and bring Mabel.
E.D., is she all right?
She's fine. So what we got?
Listen, I've been thinking. And the fact is, some people are going to be resistant if we say this protest is connected to our chapter of the NAACP.
Because they're cowards.
That may be so. But chastising them will not get them on our side. E.D., people are just trying to live their lives.
What do you propose? That we hold their hands as not to disturb their slumber? Damn it, man, we are here because no one is standing up.
Listen, we need to form a new and separate committee. That way, any negative backlash won't reflect on the NAACP.
Yeah, we need the ministers. They can get the word out to their congregation.
Yes. Yes, that's what we need.
And we need the papers to cover it.
No, wait a minute. That might be dangerous.
Oh.
If we tell them this early, the mere tactic could shut us down before we even get started.
I have a friend that can help.
This time of night?
Yeah, he's a writer. He never sleeps. Joe, Nick here, and I need you to meet me tomorrow at Union Station, 6:45 sharp.
Come along, ladies. Come along.
Are we supposed to be here?
Shh. Oh, okay.
When I was a little girl, we didn't have a school bus, so we'd walk 2 miles along the side of the road every morning and afternoon. The white children would ride past us in their big, shiny bus. And they'd throw trash outside the window, trying to hit us. So, when we heard them coming toward us, we'd step off the side of the road and into the field where the apple cores and bottles couldn't reach us. I'm not stepping off the road anymore. Mm-mm. Not for anyone.
Yet again, a Negro woman has been removed from a city bus and jailed for refusing to give her seat to a white man.
Refusing to give her seat to a white man.
How long before it is your mother or sister that is dragged from a bus against her will? It is time for the Negro to demand the rights that we deserve.
Deserve.
Therefore, on Monday.
Monday?
Monday, the day of the trial.
The day of the trial.
All Negroes stay off all Montgomery buses.
Off Montgomery buses.
Do not ride the buses to school or work. The time for boycott is now.
Boycott is now.
The time for a boycott is now. And Monday, December 5th, is the date. Okay, done.
Mrs. Robinson, are you sure we're not gonna get in trouble from the school for doing this?
No, baby, I'm not.
Well, at least if I get kicked out of school for this, it'll be worthwhile.
Good, now. Ladies, let's get this old dog running.
Three days. 3 days isn't a lot of time to pull this off.
I thought 3 days is all we got.
People are going to be nervous. Look, you need to present it calmly.
And just what is it you're trying to say?
That your temper can often get the best of you.
Good. Can you see the smoke?
Oh, I see the smoke.
All right, well, that's good. Because you will be fooling yourself, Mr. Gray, if you think that people don't need to see a blazing fire to realize they are in a burning house.
And you're the fire.
That's right. I am the fire. And Mrs. Parks was the spark. Now, I'm going to phone over to Mr. A. Phil Randolph to get him on board.
There's a lot at stake over the next few days, Mr. Nixon.
Mr. Gray, there is a lot at stake tonight.
Let me handle this. I'll talk to him.
Can I help you?
Good evening, sir. I'm Professor Robinson, English Department.
It's awful late, Professor.
Oh, it certainly is. But it's finals week, and you know how things go. You have a good evening. Ladies, come along. Come along.
There'd never been a bus boycott before, so we had to do it right. But I couldn't help feel responsible if anyone was to get hurt. Unfortunately, change doesn't come without risk.
Thank you.
I knew that if we did it right, we could make a real impact here in Montgomery. And maybe even throughout the South. The world would be watching, and there was no way we could turn back now. We all prayed for strength, and then we got to work.
Ladies, come along!
Come on, Mabel.
Oh!
Hi. I hope I see you on Monday.
I'm coming!
It's good to see you, Randolph.
You too.
Listen, I heard what happened with Sister Parks. Was she harmed?
No. All is well. She has agreed to allow us to use her as a test case to launch a bus boycott.
Now, look, we need to take this opportunity to make a stand in this city. And we need your help to do it.
Well, I'm familiar with what you were able to do with the Brotherhood of the Sleeping Car Porters Union. That's a big task, a national strike.
Well, the time we have for the size of the task at hand, the city of Montgomery can feel as big as the whole world if we don't get the right help.
So what is your plan?
Mobilize every single Negro citizen in Montgomery to boycott the city buses.
On Monday.
Starting with your congregation.
None of it will work unless we can get every single one of the 50,000 plus Negro citizens in Montgomery to join us.
50,000.
Well, you have my support. But I know a young reverend you'll want to meet.
I've been mentoring him since he arrived from Birmingham about 7 months ago. Some folks were nervous on account of him being so young. 5 minutes into his first sermon, ended any doubt. Now, God has blessed this man with a gift, and he can get his congregation to follow him wherever he leads. You can trust me on that.
Well, 70% of the bus riders in Montgomery are Negroes. If we don't ride, we affect the only thing they care about the most, money.
That's very true. We all know how money can sway even the most stubborn of hearts. Tell me, what exactly do you want from this boycott?
Equal rights as citizens to sit wherever we please. Common courtesy. And that they hire Negro drivers.
A bus boycott has never been done before.
Well, we will be the first. Which is why we need to be well organized. This is an opportunity for us to put this city on notice.
One thing that I've learned is that violence leads to more violence and little change. So my question to you is this. Can you assure me this will be a peaceful protest?
Look, we're not looking for trouble, but we can't speak for the police. They have been after our citizens with a vengeance, and things have only gotten worse since they killed Emmett Till.
They want violence and disorder. That's how they prove their misconceptions of us. Now, I've not been in Montgomery for very long, but these are some of the most restrictive segregation laws I've ever encountered. If this peaceful demonstration is a success here, there's no telling what it could do for our nation as a whole.
Well, we're planning a community meeting. We're organizing.
Have it here. 7 this evening.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Marshall. Mrs. Campbell, please. Mrs. Robinson here. Is your committee meeting still happening this evening?
Oh, good.
Yes, we are launching a peaceful protest, but we do not know how the authorities will respond to this, so we need to be prepared.
Oh, that's
such a good amount. Thank you so much. Oh, yes, thank you. I'll see you there.
We had been threatened and treated unjustly, so it wasn't gonna be easy to get more people in our community to join us. We're running out of time.
So, you know, this is Pastor Johnson.
Okay,
Mr. Yeah.
Jimmy Gibb?
No, Pastor Johnson.
Pastor Johnson.
Yeah,
Pastor Johnson.
You can be a little, you know, tough around the edges.
You got a good brother. We just need a few minutes of your time, Pastor Johnson.
Yes. How you doing?
Hey, Pastor Johnson, E.D. Nixon.
Hey, how you doing, Mr.
Pleasure to meet you.
All right.
Not certain if you heard that another Negro woman was arrested on the bus last night.
Yes, I heard she was sitting in the white section.
No, sir, she most certainly was not. She was sitting in the color section and she was told to move.
Well, then she should have moved.
No, sir, it was her right not to move.
Pastor Johnson, we're here for your support. Mm-hmm. And that of your congregation for a one-day bus boycott this coming Monday.
Boycott.
Yes, sir.
Look at here. Y'all serious? What do you think will come of that?
If we don't take a stand and protest their regular practice...
With all due respect, we don't want no trouble.
Well, don't you see, if we just stay laying like sleeping dogs, hoping nothing gets disturbed, there will never be any real change.
I wish you luck. I certainly do. But I'm sorry, you'll have to leave me and my flock out of it.
E.D.
What?
Hold up. Nixon.
What?
You have to try to be a little more understanding.
Why, Randolph? Why? You just tell me why. What is good is it gonna do with a turncoat like him? I know why these ministers and how they were bought off to keep things as they are. And I bet he got that tacky-ass suit from one of his supporters in the mayor's office. No thank you, sir. No thank you.
Mr. Young, get one of those to every customer. Make sure that they're very careful because we don't want these so-called authorities making trouble before we get this thing off the ground, you understand? Hey. Everything gonna be all right. Any crackers come in here, ask you what's in the box, you tell them it's Christmas card.
Yes, poor lightning shows.
For a second. Would you go ahead and grab Wilson? Okay. How you doing? My name is Philip Randolph, and we're out here today. We're trying
morning,
to
morning, sir. The Reverend in.
Yes, sir, that would be me, Reverend Wilson. How may I help you?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean anything.
Listen, no need to apologize, sir. As you can see, the Lord's work comes in many forms.
Yes, that's right.
What can I do for you?
Well, we sure could use your assistance.
Well, not much I can do with just one handbill. I'm gonna need far more to pass out for Sunday services.
That means you'll help.
Oh, yes, sir, absolutely. Listen, my flock might be small, but, well, we sure are mighty.
Well, we're having a planning meeting this evening at the Dexter Avenue Church.
Reverend King's new home.
That's right.
I'll tell you something. Gifted that one. Yes, sir. So what time?
7:00. And I'll make sure you have all the handbills you need there.
Count me in, sir. Right. I'll tell you something. I've been praying for anybody, somebody to step up.
Yes, sir.
And what's about to happen makes this fat old preacher proud. I'm gonna see you there.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
You take care.
All right, thank you so much.
Uh-huh.
Thank you so much.
Good.
Randolph.
All right. Good job.
Mrs. Parks, I think you remember Mr. Langford.
Yes, sir. Nice to see you again.
It's nice to see you again. Charles has agreed to join me in court on Monday as my co-counsel.
Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure to help, and I hope we lose.
Sir, you intend to lose my case?
What he means is that our strategy is to lose your case, because we can't make much of an impact in the lower court system.
When we lose, we can then appeal to a higher court. The higher court means more exposure.
More exposure is a good
strategy. I know.
I
follow Mr. Langford. It's hard to change laws unless they reach the highest court in the country. I do try to keep up now. Excuse me.
Hey, Randolph, how's it going?
Yeah, good, good. It's filling up. Listen, Montgomery Improvement Association.
Yo, what's that?
That's what I want to call a committee.
Yeah. Yeah, I like it. It's good. Form a board this evening to make sure you get King involved.
All right, I'll try. How you doing?
Oh, I'm waiting on the old friend. Hey, look, I return tomorrow evening.
All right. Be safe, my friend.
Nixon.
Joe. We should all need your help. I want to put this in the paper.
Bus boycott?
That's right.
We've been friends for a long time. So I'm gonna tell you this straight. Montgomery is not ready for this. The tradition of segregation is too deeply rooted in the culture here.
Just because they're used to it, don't make it right. You of all people know that.
What we see is injustice. What we know to be injustice. To them, it's just heritage. Help them. They think it's generous that they let you ride their buses.
We need our side in the morning papers. On the front page. Joe, this is serious. I need to know if you will help us.
Can't guarantee the front page.
All right.
I'll do my best.
Thank you. And we will be in touch.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Good evening. I'd like you to bow your heads and join me in prayer. Lord, we come to you with the hope that you lift us up and impart unto us the courage to stand for what is right.
Yes, amen. Yes. Amen.
We are forever giving thanks, love, and praise
yes.
to you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We want to thank everyone for coming out this evening. We have matters to discuss. We will begin with Sister Rosa Parks, whose most recent experience has led us all here today. Sister Parks.
Good evening. Last evening, I was told to move out my seat in the segregated section of the Cleveland Avenue bus for the comfort of a white gentleman. Now, it wasn't that he was ill, elderly, or handicapped. He was just white, and that was enough to make him more worthy of a seat than me. Now, I understand that some of you might be thinking that I'm just up here trying to stir up trouble, and well, yes, I suppose I am. But I have been the Montgomery NAACP chapter secretary for 8 years now. And I personally have spent too much time logging our civil rights complaints in these here notebooks that have grown larger year after year. The fear and indignity that they put us through must not dissuade us from demonstrating for our basic rights. There comes a time in our lives when we reach our limits, when we have to move past ourselves and our small comforts and choose to make our voices heard. When that bus driver started yelling and threatening me, I saw young Emmett's face. And I thought, how could we live in a world where a smile or a whistle can equal a death sentence? Yes, it is far easier to have our heads down and just keep going on with our business, but that would only give them the power to continue to keep us down. They continue to limit our rights. They continue to call into question our very citizenship. But they will only continue if we as a community do not take a stand against them.
Come Sunday, we need you to encourage your congregations to join us. Huh? Amen?
Amen.
And this is a good plan with the potential to create real change in Montgomery. No be no need for picket signs and rallies. We simply won't use public transportation.
And how are people supposed to get to work? You want them to lose their jobs?
No, sir. We're setting up carpools. And we ask that those who work close to their jobs from their home, we ask that you walk.
And now we have work to do. Yes. And the first of which is to set up the transportation committee. And Mrs. Campbell has been gracious enough to volunteer her husband, transportation engineer, Mr. Alfonso Campbell.
Yeah. Thank you.
I should be saying we hope he accepts this post. All right, then. He is going to need some volunteers to assist him in one of the most important challenges of this evening. All right, you all follow me. Thank you, Mr. Kemp.
Our intent is to have a peaceful protest, but if things get out of hand, we'll need more assistance with the legal fund.
If anyone has legal experience, please follow me.
Thanks.
Anybody hear about a boycott? Why am I just reading about it in the paper?
Pick up and drop off locations along the existing bus routes and a list of volunteer drivers. Also, all 18 Negro-owned cab companies have agreed to charge passengers 10 cents a ride, same as the buses.
This is real good, Mr. Campbell. Mm-hmm. Real good indeed.
Thank you, sir.
Some generous donations for the legal fund.
Well, we may very well need it and more. I'm concerned that just one day is not sufficient enough to make a significant impact.
Then we continue.
Well, we'll get this much pushback for just one day. How can we continue?
Do not underestimate us, Mr. Dixon. We are educated, independent with funds, and in some states, more influential than the white folks. Oh, this will work. Sooner or later, everybody will get on board. You see.
You ain't no joke, are you, Mrs. Roberts?
No, sir, she is not.
Hey! Excuse me. We got a problem.
Bring it up, boy. Come on. It's out. They know. Reports of fear amongst the Negro community, and they are requesting police protection against the Negro goon squads, which reportedly have been organized to intimidate the other Negroes who want to ride the bus come Monday.
That's a lie. I mean, there's no such thing.
You said your friend would help us. That there? That's not helping.
Joe did not write this article, Randolph. This is from the Alabama Journal, not Montgomery Advertiser.
How much could it hurt?
A lot. People tend to believe what they read in print, even if it ain't true.
Especially if they want it to be true.
Now, let's not get ahead of ourselves. This, though disappointing, is not all that unexpected.
And who knows? This may very well help us. God works in mysterious ways.
Yes, he does.
Excuse me, sir.
What?
Give me some good news, Nelson.
We've been getting calls from employers that their Negro domestics are not going to work on Monday because they're afraid to ride the buses on account of the boycott.
How many calls?
A lot. Phones are still ringing.
That's great. That's just what we need 3 weeks before Christmas. Riots in the streets because it was goddamn. Get me, what's his name, who's in charge at the bus company, and the commissioner.
Yes, sir.
And then the mayor.
How are you?
I'm fine. This is incredible.
How was work yesterday?
Oh, it was fine. From what I could tell, word of Monday hasn't reached them, so we're good on that account.
Are you heading home now? Should we get you a ride?
No, I'm here to
Rosa.
Say what. Huh.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Please, let me get your coat.
Oh, thank you. No, I'm fine. You can tell everyone here that all these folks in here, no one can answer the phone. Law Officer Fred Gray.
All right,
As y'all know, we've been getting calls all day about a boycott. And now that it's being reported that Negroes are afraid of what's gonna happen to them if they break ranks and get on a bus, come Monday, we need 2 police escorts for each bus driving in and out of the neighborhoods. We also need additional patrols at all the bus stops. Now that means overtime. So make sure you get with your supervisors for your schedules. Hey, hear this now. I ain't letting no mess of niggers disrupt our fine city. I'm making myself clear. If we got it, we bring out the hoses and the dogs.
I'm gonna get on. Patrick and Raymond will be here any minute now.
Mrs. Parks, I know you don't particularly like talking about how you're feeling, but are you nervous? Because if you're feeling uneasy, just know that we are all here for
Mr. Gray, please don't confuse my quiet for lack of concern. Yes, I'm anxious. Now, you and my husband are the only 2 people who know that, and I'm just saying that so you don't think I'm crazy. I said it before, I do mean it. All of this is bigger than me. That's what keeps me moving. Good night, Mr. Gray. 40 hours away from the boycott. Get a wash in, or I have to follow you into court on Monday.
Good night, Mrs. Parks.
Good night, Mr. Gray. What is it? What happened?
That show as well really came through. Wrote one hell of an article, citing all the past arrests, past citations, and even explaining that we're planning a peaceful protest.
Went bad.
Do you want this run on Monday after it was done?
Oh, yes, yes, but I thought that small negative article was gonna hurt us. But instead, we got twice as many calls of support than we had before. This right here, this is gonna reach everyone, all the peoples. But you really started something, Rosa. That's Now, are you ready for tomorrow?
We're ready.
And what you're doing for us takes a very special kind of courage. All right. All right now.
This is the new condensed handbill. Looks like we're having a lot more support than we had expected, with many church leaders promising to speak to their congregation during Sunday service, Mama.
My mother was 5 years old when slavery ended, but she didn't see much change. They lived on the same plantation that she was born on. No money, no property. Living was about surviving, and that's all. And slavery. Slavery was imprisonment, and every part of their lives was at the mercy of others. When to rise, when to sleep, when to eat, when to relieve themselves, when and if to live or die. So you see, nowadays people look at what they have and they say, yes, this is enough. On this, I can get by. And that's because they remember what it was like in the past. And they remember that this is much better than living in chains. So you see, not everyone is going to step up and stand by you.
But they must see that these injustices are not just a bother, they're an impediment to our future. If we don't stand up against them now, we will remain where we are today. We have to move forward.
Rosa, hear me. Your cause is an honorable one. Your cause is a worthy one. Our people need women like you. But you are my only daughter. And if anything happens to you, my life will end. I love you, and I don't know what cause could be bigger than you are to me.
I understand. I do. But this is who you taught me to be.
I am afraid for you. But from fear we rise. Ah. All right.
Mama was right. From fear we do rise. And through example, we inspire. People don't always have the courage to do what's right or stand with what's right when they think that they are alone. But courage can come when we stand together as one. I was praying for a guilty verdict, even though I knew I was innocent. We needed to lose here in order to win in the higher courts.
Yes, sir. Well, we got a call saying that there was a colored woman sitting in the white section on the bus.
We had the seats marked and had an unexpected group of Caucasians come in, and I needed to make some room in the bus and asked, you know, for them to make some room, and everybody did except her.
Bus driver, Mr. Blake, got off and he pointed out the defendant.
Had a discussion with the driver and stepped on and removed, removed the woman.
Mr. Blake confronted the defendant, she became indignant.
Not argumentative. She never really raised her voice. We never had an argument. She just wouldn't do what I asked her to do.
And I would say she was defiant.
No, sir. Verbal force, maybe, but she ultimately cooperated.
I'd seen her on the bus before, you know, but never had any trouble out of her before.
Why do we have to disrupt the peace of society? I do not understand that.
Just kind of following orders.
Will the defendant please rise? Mrs. Rosa Parks, you are hereby found guilty of failing to comply with Chapter 6, Section 11 of the Montgomery City Code. I hereby fine you $10. Pay the clerk.
I want to start off by saying good evening to all the brothers and sisters. Those of you joining us for the first time in this house of the Lord, Hulk Baptist Church, thank you for coming tonight. This is a special night, not only in this church, not only in this community, but we're hoping that tonight begins something special. Something that'll affect us, our children and our grandchildren. So please, show some love and pay very, very close attention to the words you're about to hear tonight from a man I'm about to bring up here, Reverend King.
Evening. We have brothers and sisters, we have as a people been on a journey that for a great many years of our history has passed through the valley of the shadow of death. For much of that time, we have been bound in chains. We crossed an ocean in chains. We arrived in chains. And although it has not been that long ago that we were relieved of our shackles, we now live in chains. You may not feel the clasp around your ankles. You may not feel the binding of your wrists. But I am here to tell you that until we are afforded true freedom, until the water fountains of Alabama, until the buses of Montgomery no longer separate their citizens by the color of their skin, our journey to freedom is not yet complete. This journey will not be an easy one. It is a journey that we must take together, for we have only gotten this far because of the sacrifices of those who came before us. I stand here tonight in this most holy of places because Mrs. Rosa Parks was brave enough to set aside her own fears and take a stand against injustice. Yes. Today, we stood side by side in peaceful protest against the discriminatory practices of this city's bus rules. But it does not end here. We must continue this journey. For there comes a time when We can no longer bear the weight of the oppressor upon our backs. There comes a time when we can no longer stand idly by, waiting for the tides of change to pull us into our freedom. There comes a time when even with the burdening weight of injustice upon us, we must gather the strength to stand. And in standing, we will break these chains, and we will rise in the light of our true freedom.
Until that moment, it truly did not dawn on me that my one act had created a shift in the tapestry of this nation. And with the brilliant leadership of the young Reverend King, who would rise as Dr. King, that very night helped launch the civil rights movement, which changed our country and inspired the world.